think searching like this is the best way.
Diner haunted. Evil spirit breaks into restaurant and eats double its...
Sounds like a very hungry criminal came up with a very poor excuse.
What about this one? Paranormal. It reminds me of when I used to watch horror...
Guys, I feel like this is just some sort of prank. Or a marketing stunt to boost ticket sales. Wahua has been browsing Ghostly Grove for hours. Every time she finds a suspicious incident, she says, "Do you think Tail did this?" Problem is, any suspicious incident could be Tail-related when you think about it.
I feel like Tail is still around. But if so, why didn't he come back to see me?
He was your Tail for so many years. I'm sure he'd come back to say hi. Or bye.
Anyway, even if you don't find Tail, you're still a great judge. The success of our ghost hunting squad proves it.
Thank you, Miss Gwei. I don't really get compliments without the encouragement. Working with you guys has made me feel a little more confident. Back then, I was a useless coward. I'd hide at the first sign of trouble. Tail would always complain about it, but he'd also get me out of danger.
Reminds me of me and my brother. Sort of a love-hate relationship.
Hey, look at this!
Did you find Tail?
Hey, look at this!
Is this some
tail or no tail? It's definitely the work of a Heliobus.
Let's hurry up and get to the scene. There'll be trouble to pay if we're too late.
We don't have time for that.
Be careful, everyone. This sounds like a very...
Calm down!
I just learned a new technique. I'll use it to end your life.
Unauthorized personnel should keep their distance. It's dangerous here.
Actually, we're not really unauthorized, are we, Judge?
Is that Su Shang? And a judge? Why are the Ten Lords commissioned here?
It's a very long story, so let's deal with the problem at hand first.
Mr. Cloud Knight, sir, the Ten Lords Commission will handle this. Thank you for your cooperation.
Understood. Please, take mercy on him.
Don't worry. This sort of thing is our special...
See how you like this!
Rules are made to be broken!
Liquidation!
Judge Huahua, is he...
His life isn't in danger, but his hands and feet are spasming, and...
I feel like...
Mr. Cloud Knight, sir, are...
I think so. My weapon suddenly started...
That sounds just like...
I followed its instructions. It was only then that I realized there was a sword.
Lots of children grow up learning to use a sword on the Lafu.
I sure hope we're not thinking of the same.
I realized the boy was the general.
I knew it.
When I heard my sword say the name.
Are you all right? You should be.
What happened next was even more outlandish. Yinxing looked like he was...
Not good.
I'll take care of the Cloud Knight. You go after Yinxing.
Ah! It's Yen Qing's sword. I saw him wield it one time when I was doing drills with the Cloud Knights. I heard that Yen Qing's sword is a famous weapon crafted by the artisan. He must have encountered some kind of danger, and his sword flew...
Danger? Miss Usheng, don't scare me like that! What kind of...
I'm not sure, but the Heliobi are strange creatures. Even the sharpest sword can't cut them.
Uh-oh. I just had a thought.
If it's not auspicious, you'd best not say it out loud.
Based on what that Cloud Knight said, it isn't that Yen... Exactly.
Follow the sword. No matter what, we have to find Yen Qing before things get even worse.
We've got to catch up with him before things get out of hand.
The dock for Dragon Prayer Terrace. Judging by the sword's behavior, that's where Yen...
Should we really be charging over there? Even without a Heliobus, Yen...
Are you scared, Xuxiang? Me too.
Scared? My mother taught me swordplay as soon as I could walk. I might not be as good as the... But I am... worried. If the Heliobus possessing Yen Qing...
The General has been supporting our ghost hunting squad from the very beginning. It's time to return, even if it wasn't for the General's sake. As a judge, I can't let a Heliobus take over someone as dangerous as Yen Qing! Xuxiang, Miss Gui, Mr. Trailblazer, please help me rescue him! Yen Qing is at Dragon Prayer Terrace. Let's go!
Doing in Dragon Prayer Terrace.
It must be. Shouldn't we ring the harmonic chime and see if we can talk to Yen Qing inside the illusion?
Illusion? Since each of you can see it, wouldn't that mean you'd fallen into the illusion as well? Don't be alarmed. To me, this sword formation is a precious arsenal. And better yet, they welcome those who wish to pursue higher realms with open arms. Swordsmanship isn't the only thing you can learn. As long as you want to become stronger, these swords will show you countless ways to do so. Isn't that right, Master Apeyra?
Apeyra? That Heliobus's name is Apeyra?
Correct. Master Apeyra promised to show me the flaws in my swordplay and how to take it to the next level. That's why I brought them to Dragon Prayer Terrace, where I suffered my most serious setback.
Young one, with me, everything will be different. Whether it be Imbibed or Lune, the Stellaron Hunters, or that woman, your accomplishments will exceed them. You will be matchless, without limits.
Matchless without limits. You're just in time. The swords have taught me something already. I'd like to see how sharp my skills have become. My skills are lacking. I've been through countless defeats. But with the Pyra as my master, no longer.
Why is he attacking us?
Your end approaches.
I'll see you off.
Unnecessary.
You're all in.
Nothing major.
That paradise may be a savor it for me.
Receive divinity. Repay.
Fail to send you.
Easy, Numby.
Rules are made to be broken.
The market is unpredictable.
Right! Investing in victory means playing the long game!
Cut through the rents.
Their skills are nothing compared to mine. What can I learn?
Then, why not?
Hack them down? I thought we were just sparring.
The laws of the battlefield are no different from the laws of the universe. Life for victory, and death for defeat. Swordsmanship is the art of victory.
But...
you're resisting me? Rid yourself of these needless notions of clemency. How can you move forward without...
Life for victory and death for defeat, huh? All this talk of laws of the battlefield and the universe. You think that gives the appearance of a grandmaster? You're just using someone else's ambition to satisfy your own desire to shed blood. This Xuan Yuan sword in my hand has been passed down through my family for generations. When my mother gave it to me, she said, "The bread may bake, but the hearth remains." And for a long time, I had no idea what she was talking about. Today, I just realized I misheard her. I think she actually said, "The edge may break, but the heart remains." The Lieutenant Yinqing, the winner and loser of this battle, have yet to be determined. Don't give me that. There is no point in fighting any longer, speech.
This little wench's fighting spirit is on fire. Young one, since she insists on fighting...
I won't back down.
This is between fellow Cloud Knights. Losing a fight isn't a big deal, but if I abandon my... Granted, I might not last more than a few moves. You guys go get the general, quickly! I'll try and hold him off until he gets here.
Su Xiong, my bestie. Why is she so stubborn?
Still, that was pretty freaking cool.
The Spirit Bearer told me that the General is still in Victual Garden. Let's hurry! I think the only one that can break Yan Qing's illusion is Jing Yuan himself.
Is something the matter? You seem out of breath. A heliobus that creates illusions for the sole purpose of instructing someone in swordplay. I wouldn't mind learning a few tricks from them myself. Unfortunately, it sounds like this one is a little too aggressive to be a decent sparring partner. This is not an adversary that someone as young as Yan Qing is equipped to deal with.
General, we need to move fast. If we wait any longer, I'm afraid that Su Sheng might be...
I can understand your sense of urgency. But before I leave, I have a question for Cirrus, who has been listening this whole time.
Naturally. Among the Heliobi, Pyra manifests the courage and warring spirit of Ignamar. They are the most aggressive of all the fragments. But who is this Swordmaster? Who is Yan Qing?
My apprentice.
No wonder I smell a hint of sadness in you. In order to rescue his incompetent apprentice, the master must fight on the battlefield himself. I must say, I'm very envious of Pyra.
You know the flavor of sadness, but not its meaning. An apprentice obsessed with victory and defeat has lost his mind to a heliobus. And is now trying to shortcut his way to mastery of the sword. This is my failure to him as a master. And the source of grief you see in me now.
Then you should hurry. Pyra has an insatiable bloodlust. Once they've enslaved your mind, they can make you turn against your friends, your kin, even your own master. Go! I don't wish to delay your death match with your apprentice.
Su Sheng is awaiting our timely arrival at Dragon Prayer Terrace.
For the moment you drew your...
I didn't think I would last this long. I'm not half as bad as I thought.
Yunguan, you're hesitating again. You're always hesitating. Your opponent is no match for you. Yet they have managed to fend you off for this long. As a swordsman, have you not any pride? Do you want to repeat the disaster you suffered at Dragon Prayer Terrace? It's time to finish it. Only blood can cleanse the shame of the sword.
He won't do it.
General.
Young one. Your old teacher has arrived. Under his tutelage, you never experienced true failure. But after suffering your first major setback, your confidence in your swordsmanship has been faltering. You worry that the general is disappointed in you. You worry that you don't have what it takes to be the person the general wants you to be. Now, show him what I have taught you. He'll be very proud of your progress. Tell him that with your sword, you will bring victory to the Xianzhou.
With my sword.
Yan Qing would never draw his sword on me to prove himself. I have confidence in him. This confidence is not a belief that he will win every contest. It is a belief that he will one day break free from the paradigm of victory and defeat, and realize his true reason for wielding the sword. But this truth must be discovered by himself. No one can teach it to him. Now is the time for him to take that step.
General, I...
Break free from victory and defeat? Those are just empty words to comfort the dead and the defeated. Think of your crushing defeat at Dragon Prayer Terrace. Think of how you felt then, teetering on the brink of death. If the sword of that Stellaron Hunter had pierced your flesh, you wouldn't be standing here pondering the meaning of victory and defeat. Now is the time to break all your chains. Draw your sword on your master, to the general who is trying to imprison you. Draw your sword!
General, allow me to demonstrate my swordsmanship. I hereby challenge you. Apaira, I challenge these swords to battle!
Young fool, how disappointing. You're a... None of that matters anymore. While teaching you, I studied your every move inside out. And now you wish to throw down the gauntlet. Very well. In your own image, and with your own techniques, I will teach you one final lesson. Your swordplay, every stroke and sway, I've collected it all from memory. Now, allow me to demonstrate. With merciless intent, how powerful I am!
No, Yan Qing. Conceal your form and hide your intentions.
Let's make it quick.
Don't fall for their distractions.
Understood. Liquidation!
Unnecessary.
Repay!
That paradise may be unreachable for me. Savor it for me.
Let's go.
Punish evil!
Just a scratch.
I'll see you off.
Rules are made to be broken!
Go, Nappy!
You chose the wrong enemy. Eternal sleep is
the dead return!
You're all in, Artie. Out of moves. Steady.
Receive divinity.
Pretty good part.
Repent.
The market is on
price. Investing in victory means playing the long game!
Let's make it quick.
Your end approaches.
Let the valuation be liquidation!
too little. Failed to sense you.
I failed.
One hit. One stroke of luck. One victory.
Impressive. I am bested.
Phew, it's about time we got this guy into the gourd.
General!
I know what you wish to say, Yanqing. We can move past the melodrama.
Then, to the rest of you. Thank you for bringing me out of...
Why does everyone that gets Helioblast love to apologize for it? You're the victim here. They're the ones stirring up chaos. It should be me thanking you for holding back during our battle. Or maybe, just maybe, it's due to a sudden skill improvement?
Right. Conscious Yuzhong is pretty badass. We're gonna need to get you a front-page news story for this one. Heck, let's get some billboards!
So, you've made it your daily mission to tease me, huh?
With respect to this incident, what is your plan for posting on the Lawfu's Ghostly Grove? Since it concerns the Seat of Divine Foresight, I am hoping you could.
Well, about that. Let me discuss it with him first. Is everyone okay with this?
Thanks for covering for me. I'm so embarrassed.
All's well that ends well. We should hurry back and lock Apyra in the evil binding matrix. They're a dangerous one. I'm afraid they might escape.
Well then, Yanqing and I will...
All right, let's get out of here.
Actually, I'm well aware of my own limits. If it weren't for Yanqing resisting that Heliobus, maybe I wouldn't have been able to hold on until you brought reinforcements.
Come to think of it, we only needed one person to fetch reinforcements. Why didn't we get him to stay behind with you? And why didn't you ask?
It's kinda embarrassing, but I was caught up in the moment. I guess I never thought it through.
Sometimes I wonder whether your head's screwed on right. We need to take you to the Alchemy Commission for a checkup.
Maybe, but my actions kept everyone safe, and that's what matters. Miss Ho-Ha needed someone to look out for her, and Little Quay's just a civilian. You shouldn't be putting yourself in risky situations. As for him, he's a distinguished... After weighing things up in my head, it made the most sense for only me to stay put.
If I still had my tail, I wouldn't be slowing everyone down.
Sorry, Ho-Ho. I didn't think it through.
It's not your fault, Miss Yuzhong. Forget it. We should get some rest. There could be... Thank you.
Thank you.